rid of tough, dried-on stains on contact. That's right. One product with the power of bleach and household cleaners to clean and disinfect. Tackle from Clorox.
You don't need this.
Yes, I do.
You have to be totally in control if you're going to convince Trey that this is for real.
Whether or not he believes it is not the issue here, Sam. It's what he is going to do about it.
He'll drop the divorce. He has no choice.
I don't think Trey is going to like being blackmailed into staying in this marriage, Sam.
Well, he doesn't have to like it. He just has to do it, and fast, before the press and anyone else gets wind of what's going on.
It's a little late for discretion, isn't it, Sam?
Why? No one knows about this.
No one except your lovely wife, Sam. You never should have told Myrna about this.
What?
Yes, she stopped by to pay me a little visit last night. To tell me that I would never get away with this nasty little blackmail scheme of mine. She knew all about it, Sam, and she demanded that I stop threatening to humiliate her family and send her husband to jail.
I never told her a word.
Well, then how did she find out about it, huh?
Well, Mona's not above listening at keyholes, but I've been very careful. How much does she know?
She knew everything down to the last detail. And she believes all of it's true as well, Sam, and she's out to protect you.
Sounds like Myrna. Where does she think you got all this desperate information on me?
The same place that we want Trey to think I got it from.
Your mother.
Vera. It's a long word. Oh, Kate, of course. Cheating again, Paula? Oh, just one teeny word.
I bet. Feeling much better, I gather.
Yes, yes, much.
I'm sorry to hear that.
Why, Myrna, dear, if I didn't know better, I would swear that you were angry with me again.
Did we or did we not have an agreement to keep in touch?
Yes, yes, we did, but I have no news. And since my daughter tells me absolutely everything, I assume nothing was going on.
You assume wrong, Paula. You think Trey filing for a divorce is no news?
Trey? A divorce?
Please, don't play innocent with me. Did you really think you and that daughter of yours are going to get away with this?
Get away with what?
Oh, Paula, please. Your machinations could put Lucrezia Borgia to shame. Planning Ronnie in my house as a spy. And giving her that damn tape recorder, and I know you did.
Oh, dear.
And as if that wasn't bad enough. Taking information from Ronnie, turning it over to Sloan to use against Trey. Well, my dearest, oldest, nearest friend, you get this straight. None of those rumors about Sam are true, not one word. Do you understand?
What rumors?
Was the blackmail idea Sloan's? Of course not. Had your stamp all over it. Lord knows you've had plenty of practice. Well, Trey will not be blackmailed, Paula. Do you hear me? Because it's not true. Sam would never have done any of those terrible things.
Now, now. Get yourself all worked up. You know how gray your face gets when you're upset, and gray was never your color, Harry. I'm sure that I've been in the wrong. Probably Ronnie exaggerated. Now, why don't you come on over here? Sit down, calm yourself, and tell me exactly which part of this whole story rings untrue. Ever since you saw your father, you have been preoccupied.
He's pressuring you to change your mind about the divorce, isn't he?
Dad understands my position.
Yeah, and he doesn't agree with it. He knows that a move like this could ruin your career, and he's not about to lie.
My political career is not the issue.
What is the issue? I need to know this.
All you need to know is that I love you very much. You're my world. You and Scotty.
People who love each other share with each other. Maybe I could help.
Never doubt that I love you very much. Not for a minute. But if I told you, both of us would be upset. There's no percentage in that. Besides, there's nothing you can do. I can handle this myself. And I will.
Hello. Hello, this is Maggie Brady. Is the congressman there? He left this number.
Yes, just a moment.
your office.
Thanks. Yeah, Maggie, what is it?
Oh, Congressman, I'm so sorry to bother you, but I've just received a call from a John Phillips.
Yeah, my lawyer.
He says that he has an appointment with you today at 4:30, but...
I don't have it on your calendar, and he wants a confirmation. Should I call him back?
No, it's all right, Maggie. I'll call him back myself. You have the number handy? Yeah, thanks. Okay, thanks, Maggie.
Just so I know, are you going, or will we see you here back in the office?
I'll call you later.
You go all out this time of year, like a one-man band of Christmas cheer. Your every gift has got to be just right.